A plan out there to give public schools an extra $900 million in aid. And supporters say it wouldn't cost taxpayers any extra money. NBC 15's Zach Schultz has the story.
There is nearly unanimous agreement in Wisconsin that the way we fund public schools needs to be changed. Most plans involve either new local taxes or more state support. But State Superintendent Tony Evers says he's found a way to give schools an extra $900 million without charging any extra. He wants to scrap the school tax levy credit you see on your property tax bill. Instead, that $900 million would go to schools through a revamped general aid formula.
By allocating a nearly $900 million school tax levy credit, which does not pay for one single child to be educated, into general school aids, we will hold net property taxes statewide steady.
The taxpayer would lose the credit, but Evers says schools getting extra money would have to reduce taxes to stay under the revenue caps. While that sounds like robbing Peter to pay Paul, the reform would also tweak how state aid is handed out. Currently, it's based on property wealth. The higher the land values, the less state aid you get. But property-wealthy districts can contain a lot of low-income students who cost more to educate. The new formula would add poverty into the equation. Districts like Madison, high property values but many low-income students, would get more aid. But more aid here means less aid somewhere else.
The pie is only so big, and when you start slicing it differently, someone's piece is going to get smaller so someone else's can get bigger.
The proposal would need to be approved by the legislature next year. Zach Schultz, NBC 15 News.
The three major candidates for governor weighed in on Superintendent Evers' proposal this afternoon. Democrat Tom Barrett and Republican Scott Walker both put out statements saying they were willing to listen to any ideas on school finance reform, while Republican Mark Newman says this idea would raise property taxes and he opposes it.